Looking ahead, no turning back. If I fall, if I die, know I lived it to the fullest. If I fall, if I die, know I lived in missing bullets.
I'm on the pursuit of happiness, and I know everything will shine. Ain't always gonna be gold.
I was definitely in a little bit of a rush today. Scampled out the door, made some coffee, that's it. Today we got to bring our little toothies because they're gonna clean them, sterilize them, have them ready for us when we need to use it. And we're starting this morning with PRDS, Preventative and Restorative Dentistry. How are you feeling, Ryan?
I'm good, I'm excited.
I am as well. Definitely gonna try and wake up earlier in the future so I don't feel rushed and I feel even more ready for class. But still, strong start to the first day of classes.
Tomorrow, rather lay awake in the bed full of sorrow.
I'm on the pursuit of happiness, and I know everything is shining.
Discoid cleoid carver. Its carving ends are very small. One's called a discoid end and one's called a cleoid end. Discoid cleoid. I always get confused as to which is which. Discoid, I think, is the more rounded end. The pointier end is probably the cleoid end. Discoid cleoid. Everybody finds discoid cleoid. Okay. It's good for carving.
Yeah, got it, thank you.
So the next instrument I want you to find is called a burnisher. It's double-ended, it's a small ball on one end and kind of a football shape on the other end, teardrop football shape.
And some of those instruments are now on the little side. You have to look
so that is called your burnisher.
Yeah.
We're gonna use that as a what we call a pre-carver. Before we carve our filling, we make sure a lot of excess from overfilling the preparation is removed by using the burnisher. Then you have a cement spatula. You're going to notice in your cassette. So we mix cements and liners with that. Then I want you to find your amalgam carrier. Get full of amalgam and have the amalgam harden in it because that will ruin it. System, and I believe in morphology you're also going to learn the system they use in Europe. Canines, the cuspid, the eye tooth, and the upper arch, those are teeth number 6 and 11. And I also always remembered the upper and lower first molars. So the upper first molars are numbers 3 and 14. On the lower arch, I remember 22 and 27 are the canines. And 19 and 30 are the first molars. Another word for premolar is bicuspid. Why bicuspid? Because it has two cusps. Bi.
So we're bringing this home like good students to study.
Yeah.
Some things that we learned. And no, I thought the lecture went around the same speed as college, and then all of a sudden, at one point, halfway through,
clicking through the slides,
like literally, you could not even read what was on the slides. They're just going so fast.
Definitely gonna have to review that again.
Yeah. Probably like 4 times faster than college. Yeah. At that point, I was like, oh, okay, there we go. This is what I was like waiting for. Okay, back from the first ever class of dental school. We were finally learning about dentistry. We were going over our armamentarium, which is a fancy word for our instruments. And our professor, Dr. Graham, really wants us to call it instruments or armamentarium, more so instruments and not tools, because that's his pet peeve. All the names of these instruments, not tools, instruments. So all of these bad boys. I decided to bring them home as well as a lot of other dental students because, well, we have to remember which one is called what. We also learned about the basic anatomy of a tooth, like what a medial, lateral, occlusal, all of those terminology. The most fun fact that I learned today is that tooth decay is actually contagious. So you have to be careful who you're kissing. I didn't have time to eat breakfast today, but luckily our generation has created a nice scientific word for it. And so I did intermittent fasting. So I threw together my classic brunch. It's just regular scrambled eggs consisting of peppers, onions, mushrooms, Chinese sausage, 2 eggs, and half a carton of egg whites. Our first homework assignment is actually to track what we eat in a week and have a food log, because based off what you eat, of course, it affects your oral health, and we're gonna be our own patients, because when we are doctors and we're gonna be evaluating why someone's oral health is bad, we're gonna take a look at their food log, or like ask them, you know, what have you been eating? And that will give an idea of what we can suggest to the patient they do about what they consume into their body. So my next class that starts at 1 is called BMS 116, Structures of Cells, Tissues, and Organs. And there is a reading that we have to do before the lecture, so that's what I'm going to be doing in the next hour. Update, these are really dense pages and it's taking a long time to get through them all, and we have an unreal amount of pages that we have to go over. After I went through the first one, like the clinically oriented anatomy, the approach and terminology, I couldn't really find the tissues overview, because right after it is the integumentary system, and I was just talking to my housemate Ryan about it, and we don't think it's really feasible reading everything before class, because if you look here, we have Monday, October 5th, we have like 20, 30, 30 pages to read. Okay, that's doable. Each page takes like 2 minutes. This will take an hour. But then the next day we have like 100 pages, which would take like 3 hours if you were to actually read them. My bet is that it's gonna be more like undergrad where you, and I hope that where you just focus on the lectures and then they'll quiz you and test you more so on the lectures, and the textbook is more of a supplemental material. Lecture starts in 15 minutes, and I just got the idea to plug in my laptop to the TV through HDMI, so then I could just view it on the TV and then take notes with my iPad. So I'm gonna do that now.
Welcome. So we have a fair amount of ground to cover in this first session. This is the general information, the title of the course. This is who I am. I'm Dr. Mike McMaster. You'll learn more about me as time goes on, since we spent so much time together during your first year of school. So this is the region supplied by 5-1, 5-2, and 5-3.
distribution of the trigeminal nerve in the face makes this makes these pictures make absolutely perfect sense. That's what being a dentist is all about. That's what being a clinician is all about. You have the knowledge to explain what's going on. So why don't we take like 3 minutes just to stretch, get up and, I don't know, jump around. I'm gonna go refresh my coffee a little bit and we'll pick up again in just like 3 minutes.
Is it a real background?
No, I thought it was, because there's
on. It was literally glitching out.
I know.
Remember?
I know, like I just showed it for a second.
If you click on annotate, it gives you the ability to write on the slides. This is me making this blue line right here, but any one of you can write on the slides. Yeah, I don't know who's doing that, but I'm good with it. So you understand what that's all about. Yeah, there you go. Wow. Okay, you can stop now. There must be a clear button or something. There it is, clear. Clear all drawings. Boom. Nice, thank you. Okay, stop.
Yeah. Yeah.
Does anyone have questions about that, or can we move on to the next screen? No questions? Okay.
Okay, one sentence review for this group.
Interesting.
Interesting. Interesting. And?
Chaotic.
Chaotic.
Fast paced.
I'm gonna say, just fun. That's what I said before. Yeah, I thought it was really fun.
And that is a summary of the first day of classes at dental school at UCSF. It's everything that I could have expected. It went 0 to 100, but what we're learning is gonna be really applicable to dentistry. I love the professor so far. I love the classmates so far. Because we were on a Zoom schedule, as you saw, there were some technical difficulties and I was running around trying to find a place because I couldn't sit next to my classmate. Otherwise, our signals were interfering on Zoom and we were getting echoes. It was honestly a really entertaining and fun day, the little bit of drama to spice the lecture up. So after I eat dinner, I'm just gonna do some housekeeping things, go over my email. I am feeling really tired, so I'm gonna take a quick nap of 9 hours until tomorrow morning.
I'll be fine once I get it. I'll be good.